Yo, this one here's for all my dogs locked down in the pen. My cousin Snoop, Big Mane, Bruce Peterson, Strawberry, Sam Woo, Lil Meezy. What y'all, I forgot about y'all or something? Gorilla Records is in full of busy. It's going down for the new millennium, baby. Y'all better tell them boys in there who I am, man. You know me.
There are 2 million Americans behind bars. 1 in 5 will be sexually assaulted while incarcerated. The victims tend to be newcomers, non-violent drug users who have doubled the prison population over the past 10 years. In prison, if you're turned out, you've been sodomized, tossed to the vultures, marked as a punk, forced into enslavement, or made a prison wife. You can be turned out through brute force, or they get you with threats and their con games. In the South, roughly 85% of the prison population is black. 15% white. Most of the victims tend to be white. Mindy started as a prison boy.
The game is in the penitentiary, a set of rules dealing with homosexual activity. You know, you got what you call boys and sissies. Then you got your man.
Your man, the penitentiary daddy, the sissy, the reigning queens, the boys, punks, turnout errand runners.
I was looked at to be turned out, you know, what they call fresh meat. I've had knife pull on me. I've been told that I'd be on TV, you know. My folks would see me on TV, dead, you know, murdered in Limestone Penitentiary.
Limestone is the largest lockup in the nation's poorest prison system.
One more, get it.
So this particular guy was here before. He was a blood. In Alabama, you know what I'm saying, a lot of places, you know what I'm saying, they don't believe in a white guy being a blood.
That situation there was really fucked up. The guy, he was a blood, true enough. When I arrived at the prison, I was introduced to him. I had feelings for him, lust. At first, it kind of struck me, you know what I'm saying? They were telling me, hey, man, this white dude, he's blood also, you know what I'm saying? So I felt like, well, hell, he had to show some type of heart. But by us acknowledging him as blood, I pushed that lust to the side.
As far as bloods come, they wasn't with that shit. They had told Lamarck and JG time and time and time after again, you know, you need to quit fucking with them sissies because, you know, that's making us look bad.
It was football season, you know, and every motherfucking prison gonna watch football. So.
So this guy in particular, he had painted a lot of satanic stuff on the wall inside one of the dorms here.
The captain and the lieutenant, they come around to do daily inspections of the whole dorm. So they go in the closet and they see all this shit painted on the wall and they go off. I mean, they have a fit. Until we find out who vandalized his room, gonna be no football.
But he is a blood, so nobody can't go clutch him out.
Another blood come to me, say, hey man, you know who put that shit in that room? I said, nah, who? So he tells me, he say, blood did it, the little white boy. So I'm like, what?
Once again, Mark sees the opportunity to begin his mind games.
I walk him around the prison compound, we talk. I basically let him know, you know what I'm saying, how I had felt betrayed by what he did. Basically, I just made him feel guilty. I started to put my plan into making. So I let him know that I want him to be with me. I let him know that I want to have sex with him. I let him know I want to lay with him.
Been drinking, been smoking some reefer or whatever, and I go to my little brother's cell, or I call him my little brother, Mark.
This is my righteous dog, you know what I'm saying? He comes in.
So I asked him, I said, man, you know what you did could have got a lot of people messed up. So he like, yeah.
He doesn't make it any better. He jumps right in.
I said, what if we rape you right now? How will you like that?
He started crying and begging and pleading. You know what I'm saying? Mark, I don't want to be like this. I don't want to be gay. I don't want to. But at this time, you know what I'm saying? I'm out of control. I don't want to hear nothing. No talk.
My little brother, he jump up and he slap him real hard. And he done got serious because he really wanted to be with this person all alone.
I tell him to turn around. So he turns, he moves slightly. I tell him to turn around again. He still doesn't want to turn all the way around. So I said, bitch, if I have to tell you to turn around one more time, I'll break your jaw. So he turns around.
Like put his hands against the wall, like spread them like the police will make you spread them.
I tell him to take his pants off. He doesn't want to do it. I punch him in the face. You know what I'm saying? I squeeze his ass cheeks. Two handfuls. He tenses up. I take my pants off. I mean, he's just sitting here the whole time. I had a pair of red and white Jordans with some red shoestrings in them. So I ain't got nothing on but these tennis shoes and my undershirt. I give him the grease. And I tell him to put some on his finger. Stick it in his ass and you know what I'm saying, kind of like fuck himself. To loosen himself up because I know he had never been penetrated before. It was his first time. That's an old penitentiary trick that I learned from some old convicts. If he screamed rape, you know what I'm saying? He had grease under his fingernail. So he greased his own self up. You know what I'm saying? I'm just going to basically lie and tell him I've been fucking him. He's been my boy. Hell, they going to buy it. You know what I'm saying? Hell, I'm going to go to the extreme and get four or five other guys to lie and say I've been fucking him too, been taking care of him. He's been my boy.
I said, what if I take this knife and stab it right through your face? I said, will you like that? So he like, he's scared now when he see this knife. You know what I'm saying?
They had a knife to my eye and one in my throat right here in my jugular. And I'm telling him, I can just feel him, you know, sticking me. And it's like, if they put any pressure on him, it's going to cut me wide open, you know?
I go to fucking him. You know what I'm saying? Slowly at first, you know what I'm saying? And try to loosen him up. And it was tight. You know what I'm saying? Like, he was definitely a virgin. He's groaning and, you know what I'm saying, moaning and telling me how it hurts. So, you know, I bag out a little bit. At this time, my dog, he had the door. You know what I'm saying? He's standing in front of the cell. So he's like, man, come on, man. Goddamn. Go on, hurry up, man. I want to get straight, too. I said, well, come on. I get up off of him.
I'm in the middle of it. Now I'm there, so I can't welch out now. You know what I'm saying? I got to go on, go through with it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like stuck there in here with him.
He greased himself up. He shows him no mercy. He fucks him for real. You know what I'm saying? So I had to tell him, hold up, man. You know, slow down, chill out, man. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to hurt him for real. You know what I'm saying? Then he got to go to the hospital, and you know what I'm saying? That's going to automatically, he's going to automatically have to say what happened.
He have sex with him first. Then I have sex with him. Then he have sex with him. I have sex with him. Then he have sex with him. And then that was the end of it.
So I didn't finish it first. You know what I'm saying? So I fucking, you know, I come off. I get my due. Next day, you know what I'm saying? He goes to SEG. In prison, that's lockup.
So I'm like, in my heart, I'm like, damn, we through. We didn't got us a rape case.
They was telling me bullshit about, like, you know, if you get in trouble, so we're going to go up there and lie and say you brought it on yourself and shit like that. And I was believing them. They had me in a position where they had me spooked. You know what I mean? Because I was looking to make parole and everything, and I wasn't trying to get in no conflict.
I said, you got two choices. You can either be with me, or you can go pack your shit and go tell them folks to lock you up. You go back to lock up.
Reluctantly, Matt agreed to become another one of Mark's boys.
Only thing I ask of you, don't try to make me be like a sissy. a girl inside a prison. We hook up, you know what I'm saying? Everything was lovey-dovey, you know what I'm saying? Relationship was gravy, all good. I transferred.
The warden had Mark shipped out of Limestone again, but everyone knew Matt had been turned out. The other men all wanted their shot.
And he got this other dude, you know what I'm saying? He wound up having sex with him. He was doing so bad. So he wound up selling to another dude, and that dude wound up selling to another dude. And all this, what he was going through, was a result, because nobody messed with him. He was a blood.
He just went crazy. He just went to sleeping with different guys. I mean, just tossing ass up, you know what I'm saying? Letting everybody fuck.
It was just something that happened in the penitentiary that I left in the penitentiary. I mean, even the girl I got now, I mean, she's a fucking fox. I can't lose her about some humbug shit, you know? I mean, if I can keep it from my family for, I done 4.5 years, and then now I'm out 6 months, and they still don't know, have any idea, I don't think it'll be a problem. And they ask me questions all the time. How was college like and shit? I guess the penitentiary made me a real good liar.
If he stayed gone for 5-6 years or whatever, if he ever come back to prison and there's someone in prison that remember him from then, he will always be a boy.